Well, first I wanted to address the issue that it was going to help to reduce social welfare programs, which was something that the affirmative said the last time. That unemployment rates were not going to be affected, and the added income from raising minimum wage was going to reduce social welfare programs, when in fact it doesn't. According to economist James Shirk, when the minimum wage rises, employers reduce hiring, and unemployed workers qualify for a lot more benefits than employed workers do. So the percent that was originally employed at minimum wage that now lost their job is going to be able to receive more benefits. So now we have 500,000 people more that we have to support on social welfare programs. Also, Joseph J. Sevilla, Associate Professor of Economics at San Diego State University, says, the minimum wage fails to reduce net poverty because of its adverse effects on employment and poor ability to target workers living in households below the poverty threshold. So once again, we're not addressing those issues that we're trying to address. She also said that they're not teenagers, that they're head of households. Well, majority are head of family, working full-time and head of household, while most minimum wage workers work part-time. So according to Labor Statistics Bureau, among adults 25 and older earning minimum wage, 75% live well above the poverty line of $22,350 for a family of four, with an average annual income of $42,500 per year. That's 75% of those that are working. They're not working full-time, they're working part-time. This is possible because more than half of the older minimum wage earners work part-time, and they are not the sole earners in their household, so they're actually a double. And a small percent are actually head of household. In that same statistic, 83.5% of employees whose wages would be increased by minimum wage are either live with their parents, which means they're teenagers, or they live alone, are part of a dual earner couple. So there are two people living in the family, which is what we're talking about. Also, it doesn't affect the poor, which she said it was going to raise all of these people out of poverty. Well, according to the U.S. Department of Labor, in the recent federal minimum wage increase from $5.15 to $7.25, only 15% of workers who are expected to gain from this living in poverty were in poor households. Only 15.8%. She also stated that it was going to stimulate job growth. Well, James Dorn, PhD, Economics Vice President for Monetary Studies, says that a recent study done by Jonathan Meir and Jeremy West, economists at Texas A&M University, found that the most prominent employment effect of minimum wage laws is a decline in the hiring of new employees. So now we're going to stop job growth. Also, it doesn't stimulate the economy. By raising the minimum wage, research has found no link between an increased minimum wage and economic growth. One study found that while minimum wage increases have no effect on GDP generated by more highly skilled industries, there may be small to modest declines in GDP generated by low skilled industries. It's not going to stimulate our economy. It's going to hinder job growth, and it's not going to help the poor we're trying to target.